The next speaker is Elamaran Karim.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. First of all, I salute the frontline health workers, police personnel, ASHA workers, Anganwadi workers, who are fighting in the forefront to control the spreading of the coronavirus. Sir, I would like to point out some important issues related to the life of our citizens during the pandemic time. The first COVID case in India was reported in the end of January 2020. Till the date of announcement of lockdown, we had around 2 months in hand. This time was not effectively utilized by the government for planning our course of action. The incidents such as migrant exodus and unnecessary panic among the citizens as the result of lack of planning and lack of awareness among the people. Even then, we didn't learn. The alarming countrywide surge of the second wave of COVID has thrown the lives of the people in total jeopardy. The daily infection count had become the world's highest for so many days. Number of daily deaths too had surged. A substantial part of the deaths were preventable as they were caused due to non-availability of basic infrastructure, oxygen, hospital beds and essential medicine. The vaccine policy of the Government of India, putting profit over the precious lives of the people in the wake of the severe health emergency following the second wave of COVID. The inefficiency, negligence and cruel insensitivity of the government towards the people's miseries, which wasted one precious year only with sound bites to media, instead of making adequate preparations by strengthening and expanding our health system and vaccine production, has created this alarming situation. Sir, throwing the lives of the people in total jeopardy in our country, so far the vaccinations were free and universal in our country. At a time when the states are not given the promised doses of vaccine, it had severely affected the first phase of vaccination itself. Everything is being utilized for the publicity of the government. In all the areas we would see hoardings thanking the government for announcing the new vaccine policy. What is the reality? The discriminatory vaccine policy of the government had attracted countrywide criticism, and the Supreme Court itself was forced to intervene in the vaccine policy. All these have compelled the government to withdraw the anti-people vaccine policy and announce the present one. So the government has actually forced to withdraw its faulty and disastrous vaccine policy as a result of strong opposition. Sir, the people will reject the condemnable effort by the Prime Minister through his national broadcast to level false charges against state governments and shift responsibility. We would see that the failed vaccine policy has not been fully reversed. The government has chosen to continue dual pricing policy. As much as 25% of vaccine production is still reserved for the private sector. That vaccine goes to the upper class of the society. As much as 25% vaccine production is still reserved. This is nothing but a license for loot the private manufacturers to make super profits. Further, at a time of acute vaccine shortage, the continuation of such a policy will dilute and weaken the need of universal vaccination essential to prevent a third wave of coronavirus. Only the rich can afford the exorbitant pricing of vaccine for the private hospital permitted by the government. Our party CPIM had demanded for withdrawal of the 25% reservation for the private sector. The central government must procure all vaccine manufactured in India and bought globally and distributed to the states in consultation with them. Sir, during the second wave of COVID, India recorded 4,529 deaths in a single day. More deaths due to COVID in a single day than any other country in the world, any time during the pandemic. Number of daily new cases and the number of daily deaths which crossed 4 lakhs and 4,500 respectively are reported to be gradually coming down. It is though not uniformly across the country. According to international and national experts, these figures are highly underreported. The actual number of infection and deaths are estimated to be at least 5 to 10 times more. During the first wave, we have been shocking images of thousands of migrant workers with their families and children marching hundreds of kilometers on the road and railway tracks. Many died on the way due to exhaustion and hunger. In the second wave, the disease spread even to remote villages where the people hardly any health infrastructure or medical facilities were available and affected more young persons. The visuals of COVID patients outside hospitals, waiting for hours and days for bed, many dying before they could get one was horrifying. Several patients still unknown to each other sharing one oxygen cylinder on the pavement of outside a hospital. Families unable to find slots to cremate their dear ones. Bodies floating the holy river of Ganges. And their families wiped out within days. Hundreds of children left orphaned, overstressed to doctors, nurses, and other medical staff. These horrifying images will be haunting us for years to come. Despite the disease being found in the country in January 2020 and spreading in several states, the government did not act with the required urgency to contain its spread during the first wave. The government failed in addressing the second wave also. The world have already faced second and third waves. None of
these
have opened the eyes of the government. Government made our country fail to put the lives of the citizen in jeopardy. And last point, sir, lakhs of workers have lost their employment and their income. According to CMIE report, 12.2 crores drivers have lost their job due to the lockouts and shutdowns and other actions. Sir, the number of employment in 2020 was 39.6 crores, which was reduced to 28.2 crores in the April. In the month of April 2021. See, 41 lakhs youth have lost their employment. As per COVID package, these poor people who have lost their employment and income are not subsidized. After repeated requests from our parties and trade unions for substantial financial help to the poor, these informal sector workers, in the COVID package, there is nothing to help those workers.
This
attitude should be changed, and the universal vaccination should be done immediately to prevent the spread of
COVID further. The next speaker is Professor Ram Gopal Yadav.